And we're back. And that was literally the fastest I could do it, because I am enthralled and I'm wanting to play.
The smuggler, he's in here.
So the friend has told me that like moving is a possibility and like not fighting.
We got a man down. The smuggler's escaped.
Locate the target and eliminate him. We'll search the other floors.
Yes, sir. Search the floor. Find that smuggler and shoot him on sight.
But like, I don't want these people coming up behind me. Is my position. I didn't even consider it there. The hat. Wouldn't blood samples be enough to grab the cordyceps? Okay, I think I see what it is. No, that's not what he's doing.
Oh my god.
Man down, man down! Run out!
Same on my end!
Anything
This is bad.
Pretty much an M4.
Watch yourself! Another body over here!
Let's keep searching.
Move.
Another one down! Let's keep searching.
Oh man, that was close.
Watch my back. I got him.
Okay, go.
Got it.
God damn it!
This started off real good. I like how the weapons flashlight is still on.
Hey, don't let him get away!
There he is!
Probably 30 round capacity. God damn it. This is very important business.
Fucking go!
Right fucking here. looking for Rex.
Down this way. Stay alert. Oh, dear God.
Okay. It's just a flashing light.
Come on down there.
I don't trust it. I don't trust that door. That's suspicious.
April 28th. Marlene was right. The girl's infection is like nothing I've ever seen. The cause of her immunity is unclear. As we've seen in all past cases, the antigenic titers of the cordyceps remain high in both the serum and the cerebrospinal. Cultures taken from the patient rapidly grow cordyceps and fungal media in the lab. However, white blood cell lines, including percentages and absolute counts, are completely normal. There is no elevation of pro-inflammatory cytokines, and an MRI of the brain shows no evidence of fungal growth in the limbic regions, which would normally accompany the prodrome of aggression in infected patients. We must find a way to replicate this state under laboratory conditions. We're about to hit a milestone in human history equal to the discovery of penicillin. After years of wandering in circles, we're about to come home, make a difference, and bring the human race back into control of its own destiny. All of our sacrifices and the hundreds of men and women who've bled for this cause, or worse, will not be in vain.
I'm still not being sold why Ellie has to die. Thank you.
It's 5:30 p.m. on April 28th. I just finished speaking, more like yelling at our head surgeon. Apparently, there's no way to extricate the parasite without eliminating the host. Fancy way of saying we gotta kill the fucking kid.
Why, though?
And now they're asking for my go-ahead. The tests just keep getting harder and harder, don't they? I'm so tired. I'm exhausted. And I just want this to end.
Oh, fuck yes. But, okay, so, like, where I'm at is, why do you need to take out the whole parasite? Why don't you need, or why are you unable to just get some of it? Because, like, the whole point right now is studying, right? So, like... Oh, fuck. Yeah, so, like, they need the cordyceps that mutated, that infected Ellie, in order to make their vaccine and do their science, right? So, like, they already said that they were able to grow cordyceps from blood samples. So why not use those? I would be ending the episode, by the way, but I think the game is about to come to a conclusion. You know what? Nah, let's end the episode. Because there's probably, like, a winding down, not just a conclusion. Cool. Thanks for watching. Bye!